Today we're going to talk about a phrase that is used too often. Many people have heard it. I don't care if it's in, you know, recovery groups, if it's in religion, whatever it is. The statement that an individual needs to have a belief in something more powerful than themselves is one of the greatest lies told to a human being. Okay? I'm not saying that, you know, an individual can't have a certain belief as far as who their God may be or what they do believe in. Okay? But a power being greater than yourself is never, and I mean never, going to take place. And you need to have that in your mind. Okay? Because everything that we do, we control it all. From the moment that I am blessed with another day for me to wake up out of bed, everything that I do from that point on is my own doing. I don't care what he, she, they have done, have they said, what they're experiencing. The way that I react, the way that I respond is my doing. I have made my own way where I'm at today, the past traumas. Things may have happened, but the way that I reacted, the way that I responded, and the way that I wanted to take that in the course of my actions throughout every day beyond that was my decision. Okay? Come on, Jesus, please let this happen. Come on, God, let this happen. They're not just going to come down miraculously and just put everything there in front of you. You have to take the steps to make things happen. I'm not saying don't pray. I'm not saying don't go to your church or whatever the case may be. But you have to take the actions, okay? Just because you walk into the church building every day or every Sunday or whatever day you choose to actually pretend like you're going there, just because you're walking in them doors doesn't mean that, you know, your rent's going to get paid, your mortgage is going to be paid, you're going to have gas money for this week, your kids are going to be fed. You have to do that, okay? Hanging crosses in your home or at temples in your home or whatever the case may be is not going to get anything done. It may be a reminder to you to carry that spirituality inside you, but it is not going to progress you in life. Okay? You can pray for people's well-being. I wish the best for everyone. I pray for individuals. Okay? But in the same sense, though, in my prayers, my actions and the things that I do are going to reflect that towards that individual. You know, people stay at home. They're 5 minutes away from the hospital or 5 minutes away from an individual's home. Oh, please help them get well. But you're not going over to their home and taking time to take a visit to see if there's anything that they need to tend to them. You're just leaving it in a prayer hoping some miracle is just going to pop down upon them. Okay? The power greater than yourself is the education, the drive, the actions that you're going to do to go out there and achieve what it is that you want to achieve. Period. Okay? If you're strung out on dope or you're an alcoholic or you just can't get shit done, you're uneducated. You're just sitting there praying and hoping that some power is going to come down and remove that addiction from you, remove that disease from you, take that individual out of your life as a crock of shit. You need to do it. Okay? We are only going to be as strong as we build our minds to be. We're all going to have traumas. We're all going to have mishaps. We're all going to have failures. Okay? I ain't met a motherfucker yet that hasn't experienced something. But what they've done to overcome that and use that as a fuel and let that be the powers that be to actually move forward is why an individual is in the place that they're at today. This is because they sat in a chair, kneeled on the stool, and sat there and said a prayer, and all of a sudden, miraculously, everything was gone. All of a sudden, all the memories of the trauma and the failures and the past happenings that happened just are erased. It's not going to happen. Show me a motherfucker that has had everything just erased from their mind of all the bad things that have happened that didn't take any kind of course of action to progress forward. And then maybe, I might say, okay, hey, you're a 0.0001%. Okay? But you can't do it. Okay? The power greater than yourself is you saying, hey, you know what? This is where I want to be. Putting that belief in yourself that, hey, I'm going to attain this. And then going out there and doing the things that take it, go get it done. It is isn't, oh, hey, I hope this car shows up in my driveway tomorrow. You can't have expectancies without your actions to actually go out there and earn that and to deserve that, okay? You can't expect your family members, your loved ones, the person you're with, to come home every day and just give you everything when you're giving nothing back. Because, oh, I pray they come home in a good mood. Well, what are you doing to put them in a good mood? Okay? I pray my employer gives me a raise. What are you doing to deserve a motherfucking raise? Okay? You have to be doing something. You can't just throw empty words out there like, oh, hey, let the power grant it myself. You don't cure me of this. Okay? If you're strung out on drugs, find what the underlying causes of why you used in the first place. Have a moment with yourself. When was the first time I used? Why did I use it? How did it make me feel? Okay? When Steve Jordan asked me those three questions, it took me a month before I like even understood. He kept buying me journals. Hey, put it in here. And it was just a lost, you know, but once you find out that why, how you felt, and then why you continue to do so, you will be able to eliminate the things in your life that are keeping you there. That are, well, you may have triggers, you know, because it does change your body, but when you go out there in the world, your decision to actually pick up and use again was your choice. The motherfucking needle didn't just jump up out of your pocket like, oh, okay? When you got fired, it wasn't because that you were here every day doing your job. It was because you came in late all the time, you took off of work, and half the time when you were sitting there, you're slacking. That's why the fuck you're out the door. And you say, oh, I pray that I get another chance, I swear. Take the actions that are reflecting your prayer, okay? Praying to a cross or a small temple or a Buddha or I don't care what it is, it's not going to get it done. Okay, the idol that I look to is a doorknob, okay? Because through every door is going to be an opportunity for me to grasp a hold of, for me to make that change, for me to make that progression, for me to advance and advance and advance, okay? And if I'm turning a knob and it's a little, I'm kicking the motherfucker in. I'm going to make it through the other side of that door because that's where I want to be, okay? And upon opening a door on the other side, there's always going to be a chance that something's going to lie there that's going to, you know, drag you back a little bit. But you have to make that sacrifice and you have to have that determination that, hey, you know what, no matter what happens, though, I'm going to keep progressing through this door. Okay? Sometimes we open the wrong doors. It's going to happen. It's life. Okay? But if you see something on the other side of that door and then you finally just kick it in and all of a sudden, hey, I have this. Okay? You have to make that effort. Okay? So I see doorknobs everywhere. So my higher being is with me no matter where the fuck I go because I know that, hey, as long as I take these actions and I do this, I'm going to attain whatever it is that this higher being wants me to obtain. Because I am the power greater than myself. Because if I fail to do things, I'm going to be down here. You know, but when I start making the progression and I start making the choices and I start making the decisions and I start taking action to them, I'm going to finally make that progression and get to the places where I need to be. With family, with business, with friends. Okay? And if their doors are revolving doors, they're getting the fuck out of my life because I'm not going to have a revolving door. Okay? And you need to take that into consideration and you need to look at what your little mindset is if you're sitting around hoping that some great thing's just going to fall in your lap one day. I pray I win the lottery. What the fuck are you going to do when you win the lottery? Your mindset's still the same. Money ain't going to change that. It's going to make it worse is what it's going to do. If you're barely making enough to scrape by. And you can't make the decisions on, you know, how to better reserve your money, how to have some put aside for emergencies. Once you have, I don't care how much money you have, you're never going to have that mindset and have that discipline to be able to say, hey, you know what, I can progress with this, no matter how much I have. I slept under a bridge for 2 years. For 2 years, I slept under a fucking bridge, wearing the same three pairs of clothes, okay? You think I didn't sit there and pray? You don't think I was embarrassed, you know, going to friends' homes like, oh, hey, I was just up all night, man. I was just partying, you know what I mean? You think I could, you know, wash up a little bit? But I'm sitting there, and until I actually took that action, I couldn't crawl out from underneath that bridge. That's a fact. Okay? going to prison. Oh my God, I swear to God, I'm going to stop drinking and driving. 5 days after release, get another DUI. A prayer is not going to get you anywhere unless you take the actions to change yourself, to make yourself that higher being and caring what the fuck nobody else says about you, what other actions happen to you. I don't give a fuck, this is who I'm going to be. That's the greater power, okay? You have to make that decision that, hey, this is me, and this is where I want to be. If you're content where you're at, hey, stay content where you're at. Quit closing other people's doors and stay the fuck out of the way, all right? You guys, if you need to reach out, you know the drill, 727-415-2308, 833, I'm 24 hours a day here 24/7, 833-437-3247, SOEO.org, and Bagby at SOEO.org. I love you guys. Start opening doors.